In this video, I will be discussing about drug resistance. I am presenting this video in such a way that how you should write in your exam. Okay, let's start from the definition of drug resistance. The definition is when we can tell that a drug is resistant to a bacteria. It's when we can tell that resistance to an antimicrobial agent can occur when a microorganism does not respond to that antimicrobial agent, which would normally kill or inhibit its growth. That means it was able to kill that microorganism before, but now it's not able to kill or inhibit its growth, right? So this resistance can be of two types. Second heading is types. This resistance can be natural resistance. It can be natural resistance, or it can be acquired resistance. It can be acquired. The natural means it is genetically determined. Natural means it is genetically determined. The example for the natural resistance is of the gram negative bacilli. It usually won't respond to the penicillin G. Okay, right from the birth or genetically, it won't respond to the penicillin G. And the acquired resistance means the microbe was initially responding to this antimicrobial agent, but later it developed resistance to the same antimicrobial agent. Later it is developing resistance to the same antimicrobial agent. This acquired resistance can be by mutation, or it can be by gene transfer. Mutation means what? Let's see about the mutation first. Mutation means it's a permanent alteration in the sequence of DNA, right? It is a permanent alteration in the sequence of DNA. So it can be of two types. It can be a single step mutation, or it can be multi-step mutation. What is the difference between these two? Single step mutation, actually it is by single step mutation, it is getting high degree of resistance. Okay, and by single step, actually the single step mutation, it is emerging rapidly. The example of the single step mutation is the enterococci is getting resistant to the streptomycin. Okay, then the multi-step mutation, means the sensitivity to the drug decreases gradually in stepwise manner. That is, the resistance towards that particular drug is happening in a stepwise manner, which happens gradually. Okay, the example is, it means the sensitivity to the drug, sensitivity decreases gradually. Okay, it decreases gradually. And the example is the resistance to the erythromycin, tetracycline and chloramphenicol. Tetracyclines, chloramphenicol and erythromycin. And next, let's see The gene, the first one was mutation, the method by which the bacteria is developing resistance. Is first one was natural resistance, another one was acquired. In acquired, it can be by mutation or gene transfer. We discussed about mutation. Next, we are moving to the gene transfer. Actually, the transfer of gene for the drug resistance occur by following mechanism. The gene transfer occur by following mechanism. The first mechanism, like gene transfer methods, we are discussing about gene transfer methods. Gene transfer. The first one is among all these, the first one is transduction. Transduction. Whenever you hear this name, like this term transduction, you think about bacteriophage. Okay, you should think about bacteriophage. Okay, bacteriophage. So it's because the transfer of DNA carrying a gene for resistance from one bacteria to another is by the bacteriophage. The gene carrying this resistance property is transferring from one bacteria to the another is by this bacteriophage. And the example for this is the antibiotic resistance of Staph aureus. The example for transduction is the antibiotic resistance of Staph aureus. Okay. It is the first gene transfer method. What about the second? What is the second gene transfer method? The second one is transformation. Transformation. The transformation means the resistant gene in a resistant bacteria, the resistant gene present in a bacteria, resistant gene present in a bacteria. It is released into the environment. Okay, it is released into the environment. Then what happened? This resistant gene transferred or released into the environment is taken up by the sensitive bacteria. Okay, it is taken up by the sensitive bacteria. Then what happened? And it become resistant. The example for this is the penicillin G resistance in pneumococci. Penicillin G resistance in pneumococci. The third method of transfer of gene transfer is third one is conjugation. Conjugation means what? The transfer of genetic material carrying the resistance. This transfer of this genetic material carrying the resistance between the bacteria is by a sex pilus. You should remember the term sex pilus here. Here the resistance is transferred from one bacteria to another by the sex pilus. The example for the conjugation is E. coli. E. coli, which is resistant to streptomycin. This is the example of gene transfer. This video is getting a little bit long, so we will be dealing with the mechanism of development of drug resistance, as well as the cross resistance, as well as the methods to prevent the development of drug resistance in the another video. The link of that video is given in the description box of this video. So watch that also. Thank you for watching. Bye.